Hello friends, so in today's lecture we'll study about maximum a posteriori decision criteria, which is also known as MAP decision criteria. So before understanding this, let us recall few concepts. So till now we have understood that transmitter transmits either 1 or 0, and at the receiver side there is a decision device. The input of the decision device is a Gaussian random variable Z. It has some threshold lambda. Whenever Z is greater than lambda, this decision device decides in the favor of 1, or it decides that 1 has been transmitted. Whenever Z is less than lambda, it decides in the favor of 0, or it decides that 0 has been transmitted by the transmitter. So let us understand what happens when one is transmitted. Whenever one is transmitted, the input of the decision device is a Gaussian random variable, so it will have a PDF of fz of z when one is transmitted, and this is also known as conditional PDF. So when one is transmitted, the input of the decision device will have a PDF of this. Now if the one is transmitted and decision device decides in the favor of 0, in that case there is a chance of bit error. Similarly, when 0 is transmitted by the transmitter, then input of the decision device is a Gaussian random variable. In that case, it will have the PDF of fz of z when 0 is transmitted. This is also known as Gaussian PDF, and it is a conditional PDF. Now when the 0 is transmitted by the transmitter and this decision device decides in terms of 1, then also there is a chance of bit error. So we can say that the probability of bit error arises when 1 is transmitted, intersection receiver decides in the favor of 0, plus when 0 is transmitted, intersection receiver decides in the favor of 1. Now we can write these joint probabilities in terms of conditional probabilities like this: probability of 1 transmitted into probability of receiver decide in terms of 0 provided 1 has been transmitted, plus probability of 0 transmission into probability that receiver decides in the favor of 1 when 0 is transmitted. Now when 1 is transmitted, the input of the decision device will have a PDF of Z1 transmitted. This is our decision device. Now if this decision device decides in terms of 0 or in favor of 0, then probability of bit error will occur. So now from here we can calculate probability that decision device decides in terms of 0 when 1 is transmitted. When will this happen? Whenever z is less than lambda. We can relate this to PDF and integration, so it will become from minus infinity to lambda into fz of z when 1 is transmitted into dz, because whenever 1 will be transmitted, the PDF at the input of the decision device will be this. Similarly, for 0 transmission, the PDF at the input of the decision device will be conditional PDF fz of z when 0 is transmitted, and whenever 0 is transmitted and this decision device decides in the favor of 1, then probability of bit error will occur. So this probability that receiver decide in favor of 1 when 0 is transmitted can be written as probability whenever z is greater than lambda. We can relate probability with PDF, so it will be lambda to infinity. The PDF will be conditional PDF of 0 transmission, because 0 is being transmitted, and into dz. So as a whole, probability of error can be written as probability when 0 is transmitted into probability that receiver decides in the favor of 1 when 0 is transmitted, plus probability of 1 transmitted into probability that receiver decides in terms of 0 when 1 is transmitted, and we have calculated values of these. So we can write it like this: from lambda to infinity fz of z when 0 is transmitted dz plus probability of 1 transmission minus infinity to lambda fz of z when 1 is transmitted. So this was the probability of bit error. Now we have to minimize this probability of bit error. To minimize this, we have to calculate the value of lambda such that this probability of error has minimum value. That this minimized value of lambda is known as optimum value of lambda. Now, to calculate this optimum value of lambda, a decision criteria is used, which is known as MAP decision criteria. Now, before understanding MAP decision criteria, we must understand what is a posteriori probabilities. So an a posteriori probability is nothing but a conditional probability and it gives the probability of a parameter let us say the parameter is theta given the evidence capital X is obtained from experiment. So the capital X will be the variable parameter and this theta we can consider is kind of constant parameter. Since experiment is being performed, so we can also call X as random variable. So whenever the probability is written like this, theta by X, where this represents a normal parameter and this represents a random variable, this kind of probability is known as posteriori probability. Now, so let us define this term. We know that Z is a Gaussian random variable and 0 transmitted means we are transmitting pulse S2T, which is nothing but a constant pulse of negative voltage of duration TB. So we can define it as a posteriori probability that 0 is transmitted given the condition that random variable Z has been received by the threshold device. Similarly, this term, this is also an a posteriori probability that 1 is transmitted given the condition that random variable Z has been received by the threshold device. Now, this is our transmitter, this is the decision device. So this is our decision device. The input is a random variable z, and whenever z is greater than lambda, it decides in the favor of 1. Whenever z is less than lambda, it decides in the favor of 0. And here 1 and 0 is being transmitted. Now, according to map decision criteria, whenever the a posteriori probability of one transmission is greater than the a posteriori probability of zero transmission, in that case, decision device decides in the favor of one, or decision device decides that one has been transmitted. Similarly, whenever a posteriori probability of one transmission is less than the a posteriori probability of zero transmission, the decision device decides in the favor of zero, or it decides that zero has been transmitted. So we can simultaneously write this expression: a posteriori probability, whenever it is greater than a posteriori probability of zero transmission, then receiver will decides in terms of one, and whenever a posteriori probability of zero transmission is greater than a posteriori probability of one transmission, decision device decides in terms of zero. Now, according to Bayes rule, we know that probability of A by Y is equal to probability of A into probability of Y by A divided by probability of Y. Now, whenever A is a constant and Y is a random variable, then this relation can be extended in terms of PDF. So this basically converts into probability of A into PDF of Y by A, which is a conditional PDF, divided by absolute PDF of random variable Y. So according to this rule, we can write probability of one transmission by Z, it will be equal to probability of one transmission into PDF of Z when one is transmitted divided by PDF of Z. Similarly, the a posteriori probability of zero transmission can also be written as probability of zero transmission into PDF of Z when zero is transmitted divided by PDF of Z. So we can put these values in the relation. The relation was this: so here we can put probability of one transmission FZ of Z when one is transmitted divided by FZ of Z. This will decide as 1, this will decide as 0. So probability of 0 transmission FZ of Z, 0 transmission whole divided by FZ of Z. This FZ of Z gets cancelled both sides. So the map criteria comes as probability of 1 transmission into FZ of Z, 1 is transmission, this is 1, this is 0. Probability of zero transmission into FZ of Z when zero is transmitted. Now, this is the map criterion. What it says that if probability of one transmission into the PDF of Z when one is transmitted is greater than the probability of zero transmission multiplied with PDF of Z when zero is transmitted, In that case, the decision device will decide in the favor of 0, and if this term is less than this term, in that case decision device will decide in terms of 0. Now, so the map criteria can be written in terms of a posteriori probability also, which was probability of one transmission if greater than probability of zero transmission, then it will decide in terms of 0 or 1. Now, here the maximum a posteriori probability will define the operation of decision device, which means if the a posteriori probability of one transmission is greater than the a posteriori probability of zero transmission, then decision device will decide in the favor of one. And when the a posteriori probability of zero transmission is greater than the a posteriori probability of one transmission, then decision device will decide in terms of zero. So whomsoever a posteriori probability is maximum, the receiver will decide in that favor. That is why this criteria is known as maximum a posteriori criteria, and we simplified this criteria in this form. Now, we have already calculated the PDF of Z when 1 is transmitted, which was 1 upon under root 2 pi sigma n naught square e power minus z minus a1 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square. Similarly, we also calculated conditional PDF of Z when 0 is transmitted equal to 1 upon 2 pi sigma n naught square e power minus z minus a2 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square. We can put the values of this. So it becomes probability of one transmission divided by 2 pi sigma n naught square into e power minus z minus a1 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square greater than less than, this will be 0, this will be 1, into probability of 0 transmission divided by 2 pi sigma n naught square e power minus z minus a2 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square. Now we can simplify this as e power z minus a2 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square into e power minus z minus a1 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square greater than less than 1, 0, it will be equal to probability of 0 transmission divided by probability of 1 transmission. We can take ln both sides and simplify this. So it will become z square plus a2 square minus 2a2z minus z square minus a1 square plus 2a1z greater than or equal to, this will be whole divided 2 sigma n naught square 1, 0, will be ln p of 0 transmission divided by p of 1 transmission. So from here z square will get cancelled. So we will get a2 minus a1 whole square divided by 2 sigma n naught square plus z is taken as common. So it becomes a1 minus a2 whole divided by sigma n naught square greater than equal to 1 or 0. This will be ln p of 0 transmitter divided by p of 1 is transmitted. Now we can simplify this, so it comes out as a1 plus a2 by 2 plus sigma n naught square divided by a1 minus a2 ln p of 0 transmitted upon p of 1 transmitted. Now, what is the function of decision device? Whenever z is greater than lambda, it decides in the favor of 1. Whenever z is less than lambda, it decides in the favor of 0, or we can write it like this. Whenever it is greater than lambda, it decides in the favor of 0, otherwise in the favor of 0. From the comparison, we can get the value of lambda. So lambda comes out to be a1 plus a2 by 2 plus sigma n naught square upon a1 minus a2 ln p of 0 transmitted divided by p of 1 transmitted. So this is the optimum value of threshold which will minimize the probability of error. Now, if the probability of 0 transmission and the probability of 1 transmission is similar, in that case this term will become 0, so we get the optimum value of threshold as a1 plus a2 by 2. Whenever probability of 0 transmission is equal to probability of 1 transmission, MAP criteria is known as maximum likelihood criteria. So whenever MAP is converted into ML, this is also known as ML criteria. In that case, the optimum value of lambda is a1 plus a2 by 2. Now, let us see how this value of lambda decreases the probability of error. So we know that the probability of error is probability of 1 transmitted from minus infinity to lambda fz of z when 1 is transmitted dz plus probability of 0 transmitted from lambda to infinity fz of z when 0 is transmitted dz. Now we can also write it as probability of 1 transmission plus, I can write this integration as 1 minus lambda to infinity fz of z 1 transmitted dz plus probability of 0 transmission from lambda to infinity fz of z when 0 is transmitted dz. Now I can rearrange this, so it will become probability of 1 transmitted minus, or we can write it as plus, the limit is from lambda to infinite, and we can write it as probability of 0 transmission into fz of z 0 transmission minus probability of 1 transmission into fz of z when 1 is transmitted dz. Now we have to minimize the probability, so I will differentiate it with respect to z and put it equal to 0. When we will put equal to 0, we get probability of 0 transmission into fz of z 0 transmission equal to probability of 1 transmission into fz of z when 1 is transmitted. So we can see that this criteria is similar to MAP criteria. Now if we put the values of this conditional PDF, again we got the value of z as a1 plus a2 by 2 plus sigma n naught square by 2 a1 minus a2 ln p of 0 transmitted divided by p of 1 transmitted. So we can say that whenever the optimum value of lambda is this, the probability of error is decreased, or we can say that it can be minimized. So the decision device will decide in the favor of 1 or 0 based on the map criteria, and when these probabilities are equal, then map criteria is known as maximum likelihood criteria. So maximum likelihood criteria can also be written as when fz of z 1 transmitted is greater than fz of z 0 transmission, it decides in the favor of 1, otherwise it decides in the favor of 0. So this is maximum likelihood criteria. Maximum likelihood criteria is based on normal conditional probability. It does not take into account the a posteriori probabilities.